G'day everyone, welcome back to the BNSF Birdwood Subdivision. Today we're doing something a little bit different, and we'll be taking a long manifest train with mid-train DPUs up the Helix. With the front half of the train already assembled, the next step is to add the DPUs. Our DPUs for the day are a Kato AC4400 with Tsunami 1 sound and an Atlas-8 with Tsunami 2 sound. With the DPUs connected and MU'd up, it's time to back on to the rear two sections of the train. The head end power today is one of my new Genesis Givos and one of my reliable old Kato AC4400s. With the second section connected, the whole consist now moves forward and backs onto the last section of the train. Thank you. Our train today is around 52 cars, which is about the maximum for these four locomotives, although the first four Atlas Masterline DDG hoppers are incredibly heavy and weigh nearly as much as three cars each. So we could add another six or nine cars onto this train. This video was shot with the old iPhone, so the quality is not quite up to standard. But anyway, it came from an idea from a few comments I got from my track cleaning videos, when people were asking how did the traction go with using a lubricant as such, like Inox, on the rails to keep the rails clean. So I thought, well, I'll show you what the type of trains we can pull up the Helix and give you the proof that really having a spray on your track makes very little difference to traction at all. Of course, unless you have traction tires, and then you've got big problems. We've stopped for a meet with my CV Shortcuts test train and another one of my new Genesis Jivos. Now, while 50-odd cars isn't much in the prototype, it certainly does take up a lot of room in HO scale, And this train is about 12 metres long, so it's about 38 feet. We're winding onto the Helix now, and the power is starting to dig in. The Helix is 1.8% and over 30 metres in length. Locos are at their limit of adhesion, and you can see a small amount of wheel slip from the leading units. The trailing units aren't doing too badly, but the leading ones are just about at the limit. The lead units are slowing for a red signal, and we're stopping for a meet with a southbound stack train. Thank you. Here's a drone view of our train slowly negotiating the Helix downgrade back towards West Birdwood Yard. No matter how many times I've seen it, I always get a buzz out of seeing a train wind itself on or off a helix. I hope you enjoyed this trip around the Birdwood Sub, and thank you for watching, and we'll see you again very, very soon. Hooroo for now.